Shalom, shalom. First off, give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekar Kadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS. Salutes and honors to the elect, all the brothers across the four corners who are enduring in truth and sincerity, all the men, the women, and the children who follow. So, I was with the brother this week, Amatazai from Chicago. You know, he was, here on business, and we got some time to spend with each other. And we were talking about, the Matrix movie, and he was bringing up some good points. We didn't get a chance to do the lesson, but, it was heavy on my spirit. So, Lord's will, this is edifying. And we're just going to go over a couple minutes here in the movie where Neo comes into the truth, the actuality about what the Matrix is, all right? And this is really a spiritual comparison to how we come into the truth, okay? So, Lord's word is going to be edifying. So I'm going to set the stage with a precept. This is a Song of Solomon, chapter 3 and verse 1, okay? It says, "By night on my bed, I sought him whom my soul loveth. I sought him, but I found him not." Okay, it says, so really, this is Neo, okay? In the beginning of the movie, you can tell that something was missing with him, all right? And this is something was missing with us, within us. We always knew, and it's going to speak on this, so I don't really want to talk about it too much, but, we always knew that there was something more there. And when I say that, I mean to say, to speaking with, multiple brothers, there's a general consensus that before we even came into this truth, we felt something. We felt like, we were different, or we were royalty, or, me personally, I'll speak on myself. I always felt like, I was a descendant of a king, or I wasn't just the everyday person, if that makes sense. But due to the slavery, I'm just living my regular life as a regular person, when really I should be held up as a king or as royalty. I've always felt like that. And that's because we are those people. We are the people of the Bible, the Lord's children, Yasha'Allah, the princes of the power. We are princes, okay, of the Most High. And when we get our kingdom, we will regain that power, okay? But I don't want to stray away from the scripture. It says, "I will rise now and go about the city, and in the broad ways I will seek him whom my soul loveth. I sought him, but I found him not. The watchmen that go about the city found me, to whom I said, saw ye him whom my soul loveth?" And the watchmen that go about the city that found Neo, okay, that's talking about when Trinity sent him the white rabbit, and, when they came and got him and put him in the car, and they took the thing out of his stomach, the little robot thingy, those were the watchmen finding him. And it's the same as, you strolling down the street, and you seeing the prophets on the corner preaching, prophesying, telling the word, or maybe you're surfing the internet and you came across the video. It's the same thing. It says, matter of fact, let me start playing some of the video, and I'm gonna come back to this. So I can't play the video because I don't want to be demonetized, but you should be able to hear the audio. So we're gonna play some the audio. Satan fucking with the... Come on. Hold on real quick. Okay, here we go.
"As you no doubt have guessed, I am Morpheus.
It's an honor to meet you."
"No. The honor is mine. Please, Come, sit.
And so one thing that's cool about this scene is, you know, with their first meeting, I'm going to read the scripture. It says, it was Song of Solomon 3 and 4. It says, it was but little that I passed by them, but I found him whom my soul loveth. I held him, and I would not let him go until I had brought him into my mother's house and into the chamber of her that conceived me. So really, it's Neo who's being woken up. So that would mean Morpheus is him whom his soul loveth. But because Neo is the chosen one, it's really Morpheus who is finding him whom his soul loveth. So it's actually, you know, going both ways. So that's a dope part of this. Let me get back to it.
I imagine that right now you're feeling a bit like Alice, tumbling down the rabbit hole.
You could say that.
I can see it in your eyes.
And I'm sorry, I'm going to be interjecting in this. I can't help myself, but that's how a lot of us felt when we first came into this truth. You go down the rabbit hole, okay? You start looking up, this is, you know, back in 2011, 2012, you know, you started looking up, or I was looking up, you know, the Illuminati, looking up the Hebrew Israelites, looking up all these different things. And when you go down the rabbit hole, man, it's like, wow, it can be overwhelming for some people. But at the end of the day, if you're of the Lord, you know, you're gonna end up in the right place.
You have the look of a man who accepts what he sees because he is expecting to wake up. Ironically, this is not far from the truth. Do you believe in fate, Neo?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't like the idea that I'm not in control of my life.
I know exactly what you mean.
Yeah, so Neo said that he didn't like the idea that he wasn't, you know, quote, in control of his life. All right, this is Isaiah 46 and 10. It says, matter of fact, let me start at verse 9. It says, remember the former things of old, for I am the Most High, and there is none else. I am the Most High. There is none else like me, declaring the end from the beginning, okay, and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done. So everything's already been written. You might, you know, a person might not believe in fate, but our story is already written. We're just playing out, okay, the movie. It says, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all, and I will do all my pleasure.
Let me tell you why you're here. You're here because you know something. What you know you can't explain, but you feel it. You felt it your entire life, that there's something wrong with the world. You don't know what it is, but it's there, like a splinter in your mind, driving you mad. It is this feeling that has brought you to me. Do you know what I'm talking about?
The Matrix.
Do you want to know what it is?
Before I finish that, let me get the scripture. I should have got this earlier. It says, Ephesians 1 and 4 says, according as he has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us to the adoption of children by Yahushua HaMashiach himself, according to the good pleasure of his will. So we were always supposed to be in the position that we're in right now. It's just the righteous are going to be the righteous, the wicked are going to be the wicked, and everyone else in between, they're going to play out their lives. But hey, in the kingdom of heaven, the righteous is going to reign. All right, let's get back to it.
The Matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. Even now, in this very room, you can see it when you look out your window or when you turn on your television. You can feel it when you go to work, when you go to church, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
So, and that's the world that we live in, man. We live in Babylon, where everyone believes that, you know, this is the, like as the scriptures say, the beauty, the Chaldees' excellency. You know, they believe that America's the greatest country, that they have a chance to live or survive and thrive in America. Okay. They have such high hopes, when at the end of the day, man, America's going to be destroyed, and only the righteous, only the hopeful elect are able to see it. All right. We all know that America's going down. But, you know, let me get the scripture. This is Romans 11 and 7. It says, "What then? Israel have not attained that which it seeketh for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded. As it is written, the Most High have given them the spirit of slumber." All right, that spirit of deep sleep, eyes that they should not see and ears that they should not hear until this day. Okay, so this is not for everyone to know. It's not for everyone to see, which he's going to mention that here in a little bit. Okay, this says, "And David saith, let their table be made a snare and a trap and a stumbling block and a recompense to them." That's the blue pill. Okay, that's people who take the blue pill, people who are just dead in the world, who just are content with running the rat race, okay? But we took the red pill, and I know I'm jumping the gun here, but, you know, you can see it. You know, he's taking the actual red pill. But it says, "Let their eyes be darkened, that they may not see, and bow down their own back." And it's like, "and bow down their back all way." You know, I'm slacking for jumping the gun. I'm kind of excited. But, yeah, man, at the end of the day, man, it's not for everybody, man. So everyone's not going to be able to see this truth. Everyone's not going to recognize that America's going to be destroyed. Everyone's not going to recognize that we are the children of Israel. Everyone's not going to recognize that, you know, Edomites can't make it. It's a million other things that we can and they can't.
"That you are a slave, Neo. Like everyone else, you were born into bondage, born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. A prison for your mind." "Unfortunately, no one can be told what the Matrix is. You have to see it for yourself." "This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes."
Yeah, man, so what Morpheus is doing right now, man, he's giving them that option. He's the Most High's hand, so to speak, reaching out, as it says in Proverbs 1. Okay, matter of fact, let me get this real quick. This is Matthew chapter 22 and verse 2. It says, "The kingdom of heaven is like unto a certain king which made a marriage for his son, and sent forth his servants to call them that were bidden to the wedding, and they would not come. Again, he sent forth other servants, saying, tell them which are bidden, behold, I have prepared my dinner and oxen, and my fatlings are killed, and all the things are ready, come into the marriage. But they made light of it and went their own ways, one to his farm and another to his merchandise. And the remnant took his servants and entreated them spitefully and slew them. But when the king heard thereof, he was wroth, and he sent forth his armies and destroyed those murderers and burned up their city. Then saith he to his servants, the wedding is ready, but they which were bidden are not worthy. Go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage. And that is what Morpheus is doing right now. He's bidding him to the marriage. He's giving him that opportunity. He literally has his hand stretched out forth unto him. All right? And that's our job, to go to the highways and to, as many as we will find, bid to the marriage. Tell them about their heritage. Tell them about the future of America. Okay? To lift up our voice like a trumpet and show our people their transgressions. Okay? And also curse and prophesy the downfall of many countries and great kingdoms. This one being America, a.k.a. Babylon, a.k.a. Egypt, a.k.a. Sodom and Egypt, Sodom and Gomorrah, okay, a.k.a. Rome. All right?
Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
That's all we do, is offer the truth. Whether they were here, whether they were from there.
Follow me.
All right, so he just took the pill, and we're going to jump forward ahead. Let me see, because he wakes up in the pod, and you know, they extract him and all of that. So I'm going to fast forward to the optimum place, so bear with me. Okay, so they're bringing him into the ship after he woke up outside, or in the real world, should I say. And he's you know, breathing his actual first breath of life. Okay.
The real world. We've done it, Trinity. We found him.
So now Neo's in the real world, okay? And I want to get this because it's very symbolic, okay? This is Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 22. It says, matter of fact, let me start at 21. It says, if so be that ye have heard him and ye have been taught by him, as the truth is in Yahweh Shai, that ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. So when you put off the old man and you become a new creature, then that means you're leaving your old ways. You're putting Yahweh Shai on you, okay, and you're walking within the Lord. And this is when Neo, his transition from the Matrix into the real world, okay? He's putting on a new man.
I hope you're right.
I don't have to hope. I know it. Am I dead? Far from it.
You know, he asked, you know, is he dead? Okay? This is St. John chapter 4 and verse 16. You know, when you come into this truth, okay, it says, Yahweh Shai saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Okay, no man cometh unto the Father but by me. So if you really want to go to the Father, you got to go through Yahweh Shai. That's how you're going to find the truth. That's how you're going to find the way, and that's how you're going to come to life. Okay, there's another scripture that I want to get as concerning this as well, but I'm going to let it play a little bit.
He still needs a lot of work.
What are you doing?
Your muscles have atrophied. We're rebuilding them.
Why my eyes, sir?
You've never used them before.
That's deep. That's deep. So why And he says, you know, basically, so they're trying to revive him. And he says, you know, he's never used his muscles. Okay. So they're rebuild. They had to rebuild his muscles. All right. And this is Ezekiel 37:1. It says, the hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass them round about. And behold, there were very many in an open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord power, thou knowest. And again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Okay, and this is Neo giving him the game. Or that's just like, this is Morpheus, you know, giving him the game, talking to him, you know, them working on him. They had all the it looked like an acupuncture. You know, they had all the things sticking out of his body, trying to rebuild him. Okay. But let's go. It says, verse 5, it says, thus saith the Lord power unto these bones. Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. All right. Them rescuing him out of the place where you know, the pod where the AI robots had him. All right. That's causing that breath to be in him, because you know, he was in that ooze, that goo, and then he jumped up and he took his actual first breath. All right, so you know, that's the word coming into him. All right, verse 6, it says, and I will lay sinews upon him and will bring the flesh upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Right? So now, you know, they're building his muscles and the sinews and all the different skin and all the things that make up our body, you know, and most importantly, that breath of life, which is the word of the Most High, it's all coming into him, and he's actually living a life. Okay. And one of the dopest things that was said, he's, you know, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna replay it.
What are you doing?
Your muscles have atrophied. We're rebuilding them.
Why my eyes hurt?
You've never used them before.
He asked, why did his eyes hurt? He said, you've never used them before. You know, and that's just like us coming into this truth. We've never used our spiritual eyes. Well, not say never, you know, because, you know, we've always had the righteousness within us. You know, it's just when you make that commitment to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, he then opens your eyes and you can really actually see. Okay. We weren't seeing the world for what it was, all right? But now we are able to see the world for what it truly is. All right, this is Revelation 3:18. It says, I counsel thee to buy me of gold tried in fire. All right, it's not going to be no cakewalk, no easy road. All right, this, we are the gold, and we are being tried in fire. All right, and we're pure. All right, we're that pure gold, but, you know, even pure gold, when it's taken out of the earth, has to be tried in fire to burn off all the bullshit that was contained, you know, in it. And when you take that gold out the fire, you get what? You get pure gold. This ain't no easy thing for Neo to go through. He had to wake up in the flipping pod, okay, get flushed out, get picked up by the Nebuchadnezzar, which is the name of their ship, and then, you know, get acupuncture, for lack of a better term, worked on him. You know, he has to come to the realization of where he's at. This is a tough thing. All right, it says that thou mayest be rich and in white raiment, that thou mayest be rich in white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that thy shame of nakedness do not appear. Right, so we had to be tried, we had to get cleansed, all right, that we can be rich in what? Rich in righteousness, rich in culture, rich in all the beautiful things that's going to come with the salvation of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. And that white raiment represents the righteousness, all right? And we're not going to have that shame, okay? That's why we're putting on the new man right now, so that that shame and nakedness don't show up on us, all right? And it says, and anoint thy eyes with eye salve that thou may seest, all right? Because we can, like I said, we can see the world for what it truly is. And now Neo is being able to truly see the world for what it really is.
Rest, Neo. The answers are coming.
You know, so he keeps working on them. And, you know, this is that's all I'm going to get for the video. But, you know, he keeps working on them, working on them. And eventually, you know, they start programming him. And he learns kung fu and jujitsu and, you know, all kind of martial arts. Okay. And that's the same as us. We get programmed. Okay. We get programmed within righteousness. We start watching videos. All right. We start learning the breakdowns. And that's our programming, okay? And I'm going to get this. This is Ephesians chapter 5 and 26. It says that he may sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word, okay? So when you become this new person, you get baptized with the word. The word is what's going to sanctify you. The word is what's going to cleanse you. The word is your programming, okay? So we, you know, we watch these videos. You know, take heed, download the information, all right? Keep it within you. As the scripture says in Isaiah 33 and 6, you know, matter of fact, let me just get it real quick. All right, it says, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. That word stability going back to the word faith, okay? It says, and in strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. So downloading these the information now, watching the videos, learning the breakdowns, all right, putting on righteousness, all that, okay, is the wisdom and knowledge that we're downloading within ourselves that's going to cause us to be stable, that's going to cause us to keep the faith, okay? And it's going to give us strength when our salvation is nigh, all right? And every day we're getting closer and closer and closer. Okay, so that's all I really wanted to get. Lord's word, this was edifying, and I want to give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakarkadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS. Salutes and honors to the elect, all the brothers across the four corners who are enduring in truth and sincerity, all the men, the women, and the children who follow. Shalom.